when you ask me what my goal is, it's always just to lead from a place of honesty because I try to grow. I'm not a comedian who doesn't apologize. I make so many mistakes and I will continue to do so. And I hope I don't get canceled eventually.
Right.
But if I do, I could use the break.
Nessa here with the comedian, with the hilarious Nikki Glaser. Thank you for being here today,
Nikki. Thank you for having me. What the hell are you...
Okay, honestly, why are you hating on my rose latte?
What the fuck are you drinking, girl?
It's a rose latte.
I don't... Honestly, it looks like melted yogurt. It looks like an Activia with some cigarette butts.
Yeah, it does.
But it's a rose latte?
It's a rose latte because I got sick and tired of regular lattes.
They're so boring.
They are.
And coffee is my only vice now. Mm-hmm. And it's like, I'm tired of just getting the same thing every time. I want to mix it up. I want to have fun with my latte. But the petals, do you just drink around the petals?
No, I eat it.
You eat the petals?
I do. I figured there's gotta be something good about it.
And listen, $32 for this.
Yeah, this is $3.
No way.
Yes.
A rose latte is
$3. It's a small one. Like I got a small one.
Okay.
Maybe four at most. But the mushroom lattes there are expensive.
Okay.
They're like $9.
I better be having some like experience having a mushroom latte for $9.
It's giving you the world.
Will I see colors differently? Will the trees start talking to me?
But you'll have a lot of energy.
Okay, I'll take it. I'll take anything.
Take
I can
anything
get.
Right now,
yeah.
Right?
Are you exhausted?
I'm exhausted.
Dude, it's this city.
It's the weather.
Yeah, it's the weather. It's being a woman. It's
the grind.
The grind.
Yeah.
I'm
but
ground.
You're doing good. Look at you.
Yes, look at
me. Congratulations.
Thank you. It's all
tour.
Kind of happening.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's been a big year for me. It's been a gradual progression to this weird level of famous that I'm at, which is like perfect. Like, I want a little bit more, let me be honest. That's the goal. But
a little more.
I tell you, the best semi-famous thing happened to me last night. Or the other day, I lost my wallet on Friday.
Okay.
Today is...
Wait, where did you lose it though?
Okay, so it was somewhere between, because you're like, the last time I used it, it was somewhere between my hair salon. No, it was somewhere between CVS, self-checkout, which I always do, me entering in my number. I think I just set down my wallet somewhere.
Right.
And then later on that night, I realized I didn't have it because I went get my emergency Klonopin that I keep in my wallet. It's prescribed. It's legal. And I went to get it because I was going on a date and I was very nervous. So I was like, I'll just take a half of the Klonopin just to feel settled.
Right.
And then I go, where's my wallet? And I'm like, I honestly panicked more about the Klonopin than I did about the cash, the credit cards, everything inside. But I was just like, gotta be good for this date. So I went on the date and I was like, I think I just changed purses and left my wallet at home. So I didn't stress out about it until Saturday morning. I'm like, oh my God, my wallet is gone. I couldn't find it anywhere. And I don't know, dude. I just sensed it was gonna come back. Cause I called all my people and was like, my business manager who controls all that stuff. And I'm like, I lost my wallet, but don't cancel anything. Just check for suspicious activity. If there's none, keep it open. Cause this wallet is out there and it's gonna find me. And everyone's just like, Nikki, just cancel your cards.
Right.
All weekend, I'm just like, I don't want to, I have them all memorized, which I'm really proud about,
yes.
And I don't want to re-memorize
them. I feel you, yeah.
So then Monday, this Friday I lost my wallet. Monday, last night, I got a DM from a guy who works at New York Comedy Club, a comedy club I don't even work at, but someone found my wallet.
What?
Saw the ID, saw Nicole Glaser, and goes, I think this is a comedian. Walked, where do comedians go? Comedy club. And just walked to the closest comedy club and dropped it off. And they're like, you don't even work here, but this guy just dropped off your wallet. And I was like, I knew it would come back to me. I go, who returned it? I want to give this guy a reward.
Yeah.
And they were like, he was just an anonymous person. He just left. And I'm like, I want to give him a reward. But guess what? He took his reward because there was no cash and no Klonopin. So... And my MetroCard was gone, but he left a Starbucks gift card that he or she could have taken, probably a he.
Yeah.
Left, because a girl is definitely taking that Starbucks gift card. He left a Ray-Ban gift card that I have for some reason. So I got a lot of things back. I'm just so grateful he didn't toss out my ID. Like, this is what I want. I want to reach out to criminals and be like, steal my money, steal my gift cards,
but just
put the ID in the mailbox.
Don't
throw it in the trash. It's so hard.
Trying to go to the DMV, trying to get a new ID. It's a nightmare. It's a nightmare.
Take my money.
Keep my ID.
Keep my ID. Don't take my identity,
but
literally.
That's good karma though.
Dude, it was the best.
You must have been doing something really good for that.
I prayed for the first time ever. I was just like, please God. And I'm like, I think he has better things to do than worry about your shitty wallet that literally is a case that a Sephora gift card came in. I was like, this is a cool wallet. It is literally a it looks like a Sephora. It's like black and white striped. Don't steal it. I'm getting a new one because this one has just been, it's been, yeah.
How did the date go?
Oh, that's a great question. It was so good.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's already, I already booked a second date. By the time this airs, he'll probably have already stopped talking to me. because that's just the way things go. But first date was great. It was the first time I've actually asked someone out myself and was like,
what?
Wait.
Hold up. You asked him out and you didn't have your wallet. Is it like protocol? If you're the one asking the person out, you're supposed to pay?
No. Honestly, I didn't realize I lost my wallet until after I was already on the date.
Okay.
So, but even then I was like, this is the perfect time to lose your wallet because I ain't spending a dime.
Right.
Because although I asked to be taken out on the date, he agreed to it. He's the man. I'm one of these, I'm old fashioned in the sense that you got to pay the first date.
Okay.
And the second and the rest of our lives. No.
Wait, so you asked him out.
I asked him out because this is a person that I've been like waiting for him to ask me out for so long and he just was never doing it. He'd always talk about wanting to go out, maybe spending time together, but it would never happen. And I think a lot of girls struggle with this of like, he talks a good game, he texts me when he's thinking of me, he sends me all the, I know he likes me.
Right.
Why isn't he asking me out? Well, why don't you ask him out? So I did and he agreed to it immediately and then we went out. And it was like, oh my God. And then I'll tell you, then we went on Friday night and Sunday I was like, I feel like going out with him again. And I don't really know if he feels like going out with me, but I'm gonna ask him out again. So I go, I had a great time. Do you wanna go on another date? And he was like, yes. And then we set a date. Who knows if it'll happen, but like, I'm making moves. I'm tired of waiting on guys
and
to do the right thing.
And this is your first time doing that?
Yeah. You know, I used to do it years ago when I first started like dating and I got into dating late. I discovered comedy when I was 19 and I didn't care about boys until I was like 24 again. 24 was my first boyfriend, and I just used to, when I liked guys, I would just be like, you know, I used to do this great move that I still recommend to girls. Like if you're hanging out with a guy and you want him to kiss you, and you're like, when is he gonna kiss me? And you're just like, can't stand not being in control of it. So you just like walk down the street and you're just like reaching that point of the date where it's like, we should probably kiss and we're gonna say our goodbyes. I just always am like walking and I go, oh my God, you know what I wanted to tell you? And he's like, what? And I'm like, we should kiss. I just make it seem like a flippant part of the conversation and then they kiss you. So I've always done these things that were like in control and making the first move. And then I was like, I read a book about how to trick a man into loving you. And there's all these books out there about like how to get a guy. You know the books that you ignore in your 20s and then you're 35 and single and you're like, I'll read a chapter. Yeah, I'll read the foreword. just see what this old bitch with a PhD is talking about. She might know something I don't.
Right.
And so when I read those books though, they were like, you're doing it all wrong. Stop asking guys out, stop chasing them. You have to like wait for them to come to you. So for 3 years, I've just been like, come and get me. Yeah. And no one's coming. And I'm like, my life doesn't operate this way.
Right.
I have no other part of my life have I just waited for things to happen. Mm. So why am I doing it with men? So just ask him
out.
And
it worked.
Yeah. What's the worst that can happen? He rejects me.
Says no. Okay.
Actually, that's pretty devastating. I don't want to consider it. I don't want to even think about it.
How many times have you been told no in your career as a comedian?
Like, honestly, they don't even tell you no. You just don't hear back.
Isn't that the worst? They ghost on you.
Yeah, they ghost you. They don't, you don't even get the decency of a no in this business.
They have no respect.
No. Yeah. But I've faced a lot of rejection. I was on Dancing with the Stars. I got first voted off, which was one of the most embarrassing things that could ever happen.
Right, like relax, guys.
It was so humiliating, like beyond humiliating. Like, you think that it's just a funny dance show. Who cares?
Right.
Being first voted off a show that you already feel like you are so bad at. It was that, once that happened, I was like, if I can do this and get rejected live on TV after I've just danced a tango when I was injured with a guy who is the hottest man I've ever touched in my life, I can literally do anything.
Right.
So now I feel pretty in control.
And it's working out for you.
Yeah.
Do you feel like, have you accepted all of the success? I was reading about how on Netflix, your comedy special was one of like the best from all of 2019, right?
Oh, yeah. Some people said that.
No, a lot of people said that.
That's so nice.
Listen, I know you're taking it in, but I mean, are you accepting all of like the great feedback, the excitement?
Yes.
Good.
That's what matters to me the most at the end of the day. It's like, to be real honest, what I want more than anything in this world is the respect of my peers, the comedians who I think are funniest. I do still think about that. Every time I post something on Instagram, I'm like, what are the comedians gonna say? Like, I want people I look up to like me. I got a lot of that from the special. People I'm fans of are now fans of me, which is just like mind blowing. But what it really, like, I'm trying to do with my comedy now is I've always made comedy for myself as a younger version of myself, whether it's me 2 months ago or me in high school. And so I know I've reached a lot of girls and boys who feel alone with their thoughts about sexuality and self-esteem. And I'm still navigating all of it and struggling with low self-esteem and intimacy and all of these things that I talk about. So when I get paragraphs of DMs from people talking about how I've changed their lives in some way, and I'm someone who's had my life changed by different artists, so I just know how profound that is, and I let that in a lot. But I don't, I try not to let the, and I let in the fact that I got recognized, I'm recognizable enough and famous enough that someone saw my ID.
And
was able
to return it.
Yeah, because if I wouldn't be famous, that wouldn't have happened. They would have sent it back to my St. Louis address, and God knows who would have gotten it. So, I mean, there are great advantages to, I'm so lucky.
Good, I'm glad you're enjoying this. Yeah. I mean, you've been putting in work for a while, and I think it's good to see it pay off.
Thank you.
Because it tells other people who are inspired by your work and others who just want to make it in whatever their respective field is, okay, I really just got to work hard.
Yes.
Because sometimes, you know, and I'm really not trying to be a hater, but sometimes you see people, you're like, what?
I know.
This doesn't make sense.
They won't last.
You make sense.
They won't last. Well, thank you. I appreciate that because I do put in a lot of work, but I'm not even, when I see those people get ahead, then I'm like, they don't deserve that. It won't last.
Right.
Because if you don't put the work in, you don't have the talent to support it, and you don't have, I mean, it doesn't always last, but I would say most of the time I look at that and I just go, they're going a different route. They're going to learn. Because I've had that too. Right. I got early success and I was like, I'm here. I was in college and I was on Last Comic Standing.
Right.
I mean, I was like on TV.
Yeah.
I got The Tonight Show when I was 24. I was like, all right, good night.
I'm feeling myself.
I'm done.
Of course, yeah.
I'm famous. I went to the night after I did The Tonight Show when I was 24. No one cared. There were no calls the next day. I had a great set. It didn't matter. Nothing changed. In fact, I moved back home to St. Louis right after it because I ran out of money because I was nannying at the time. I remember I went to Subway and I was like asking for more lettuce on my sub. And this girl just looked up and goes, were you on The Tonight Show last night? And I was like, yes. And she goes, I recognize your voice. It's like really husky. And I was like, oh, okay, thanks. It's big boned, but thank you. I appreciate that. And that's the only time I was recognized until like 2017. I mean,
that's
like
crazy.
I went through, you have these early successes and you can have these moments, but you just gotta, and it hasn't felt like hard work, to be honest with you, because I love it.
Right.
Sometimes it's overwhelming and I burn out, but pretty much everything I do, I'm here because I want to be here, because I love this show, and I watch it, and it's a part of our culture in New York City, Talk Stoop.
Yes.
And so it's like, I'm doing this because I'm excited to be here, and it's
really
like,
happy.
Yeah, and you're fantastic.
Thank
and I'm,
you.
And that's the thing is like going on these shows and doing all this stuff, like I learn from people like you too. Like I don't know, you're a badass.
Oh,
I can just tell
you.
Like, you're like listening to me. I feel heard. I feel like you did your research. I just.
Yeah. And I love the story. I'm a fan of people's journeys and like just you being so open and sharing that you've been sober since what, 2014?
I've been sober from alcohol.
Right.
I still,
lot. Yeah, that doesn't count.
And
so, that doesn't count.
Okay, yes, but I've been-
Alcohol.
Alcohol, no alcohol since 2011, yeah.
2011.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you. That was a major turning
major.
Point in my life. If you were gonna talk about what got me to focus was cutting out drinking. And I was someone who drank every night of my life. I was 27 when I quit. So it was just, you go out, I go to comedy clubs, I drink every night. I never could see my life without it. I could never see having a relationship without it, a first kiss without it.
Gosh.
How am I gonna dance again? How, you know, there are certain things I'll never do. A girlfriend of mine will walk in the bar and I'll never go, she's here, she's here. Like, I'll never do that again. There are little things you'll miss out on not drinking. But like, I was just able to do that now, so maybe I could do it again.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
There are so many things, reasons you drink because you're like too scared to do things in life. And when you cut it out, you're really faced with like, what do I really care about? What do I really want to do? What are my fears? And you have to face them. And so that was huge for me, but I miss it every day.
what do you care about the most? What's important for you?
I wish my answer wasn't other people's happiness, but it kind of is. Mm. But really, it's my own, because I think the best gift you can give the people you love is to like take care of yourself and to lead by example.
Right.
So that matters to me. Spreading just more awareness about women and what we go through, and,
yes.
and spreading just a message of empathy and trying to absorb empathy too, trying to understand what men go through, not
right.
just being mad at men.
Right.
Trying to understand like why their side of things. So I'm in search of promoting and absorbing more empathy in this world, and for animals, for plants, for the planet.
Right.
And that's a weird thing to say as a comedian, but that's kind of, I want my comedy to really be about like just listen to my struggle a little bit, because you might understand the woman in your life's struggle a little bit more.
That's powerful.
Yeah.
And that's important.
Yes.
Because I think it's sometimes hard to understand what someone's going through until you put it next to someone you know. Like, you humanize the situation
yeah.
for somebody. Like, I went through this. Maybe someone you know is going through this.
Yes. It's just so many people go through life going, why did they behave that way? I wouldn't act that way.
Right.
And it's like, well, you didn't grow up like her.
Right.
You didn't understand. You have a little empathy for that behavior and try
right.
to understand where it comes from.
Right.
Instead of just judging everything right away. By the way, I still love to judge. I still love to gossip. I still am a catty little bitch when
right.
it comes down to it. But I try every
but
day.
But at least you're honest about it. Like, you own up to yours.
That's it. Just honesty. Let's just be honest.
Just own up to it. I think that's really important,
yes.
right? Because I think that's why you can also be, not that you're hard on yourself, but you can critique yourself differently because you're honest with yourself.
Yes.
A lot of people live their life acting like they're perfect.
Yes. I mean,
and they're miserable on the inside.
And that's so much of Instagram is this body positivity, which I really love, which
right.
is just like, love yourself no matter what's going on. And I feel like a lot of girls do feel that way about themselves. And I'm like, I want that so bad. But I feel like a lot of girls who don't feel that way are still like, I love myself with everything I have. And it's like,
right.
I can't go that far. I can't say that yet. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Right.
I don't love myself most
right.
days. I struggle with it. I'm just being honest. I
yes.
can't lie to you and say that I love the skin I'm in.
Right.
I'm working towards it. I would love it. But I just, when you ask me what my goal is, it's always just to lead from a place of honesty, because if someone gets mad at me for something I'm saying, I can just be like, well, I'm just being honest. And if that honesty is hurtful, I can also look at that and say, well, let me learn to not be hurtful in however I'm viewing this thing. And I try to grow. I'm not a comedian who doesn't apologize. I make so many mistakes and I will continue to do so. And I hope I don't get canceled eventually.
Right.
But if I do, I could use the break.
Man, I just love your energy.
Likewise.
And I love that you're unapologetically yourself.
Thank you.
Ups, downs, doesn't matter. You get it all.
Thank
you. You put your heart out there, and you know, it's I really admire you for that.
Thank
you. It's tough out here, man.
It is tough out here.
It's tough.
I can only be myself. And the
right.
older you get, that's the only good thing about getting older as a woman, is that
yes.
you give less crap.
Yes.
And that you know yourself more. It's like, truly, I know that's just a thing that older women say, because what else do we got going on? But it's not. It truly is great.
And you don't have energy to care,
yes.
really, about the things that you used to. You're like, I'm tired.
I'm so excited to just get older and learn lessons and just be myself, be more
yeah.
comfortable in my own skin, because that's like, you've always heard that your whole life, like, be you. And it's not until recently that I've just really been like, it's all I can be. I don't have another option.
Yes.
So this isn't about choosing. It's just doing.
It is.
Letting go.
Yes. Nikki, thank you so much for being here
thank
today.
Thank you for having me on
I'm so glad you got your wallet. I'm so glad the date went good. I am going to DM you to see if the second date happens.
Okay? Please do.
Please. Of
wait.
Course. Absolutely.
Love that amazing interview. And I want to hear from you. Like, comment, and subscribe to the Talk Stoop channel so that you never miss out on the latest celebrity interviews.